My name is Manpreet Kaur, and I'm from India. And I'm presenting this paper with my co-presenter, Dr. Balwant Singh. He's also here, he's chairing the session. And the research is on the teacher's attitude and belief towards the use of ICT in teaching and learning. And these are the perspective from India. And I have done this research on the secondary school teachers to study what are the attitude and belief of the secondary school teachers towards the use of ICT in the Indian classroom. And the participant of the studies are the 150 secondary school teachers, and the method survey was used, and then again the semi-structure interview were also carried out to deepening into the major motivations and belief of the secondary school teachers of India. We all know that exchange and transformation of knowledge through information technology, now it is a feature of the developed society, and we all use the information technology for creating, collecting, storing, and using the knowledge and for the communication purpose and for the collaboration purpose. Today, many countries also recognize the use of ICT in the education, and that's why the training of ICT is necessary for the citizens and for the teachers also. So in addition to the question arises from the variety of approaches we use, how to use ICT, it is also necessary to know that what is the nature of the role of the teacher, what should be the role of the school, and what should be the role of education system in using the ICT. So the integration of ICT in teaching and learning is inevitable, we all know this. We should know that what are the teachers' belief and attitude towards the potential of ICT in teaching and learning. If the belief of the teacher and the attitude of the teacher is positive, they can use more ICT in their classrooms. The conceptual work framework of the study emphasizes that the various studies shows very positive attitude of the teachers and the common acceptance of the teacher that the use of ICT will be soon completely expanded in the classroom all over the world. And it is also seen to be that an early age is the highly relevant factor in the use of ICT in the classroom. So the young teacher, they use more ICT in the classroom rather than their old counterparts. The teacher attitude and belief is considered the crucial for the effective use in the educational setting, and it is the prerequisite for the successful implementation and use of ICT in the classroom. So what is a belief? Belief is a subjective element of knowledge, so that an individual considers true and important in relation to the specific subject, and it is bound up with a person's past history, emotion, and the personal values. And attitude, it is a complex and multidimensional construct which includes the cognitive, affective, and cognitive component also. So it is necessary and crucial with regard to the innovation in the school. If we want our school to use the ICT, it is very necessary to look into the teacher's attitude and beliefs. The research question of this is to study the secondary school teacher's attitude and belief in implementing the ICT. Then what are the challenges? To determine the challenges while they are facing while using the ICT tools in the classroom teaching, and to identify to what extent teachers use ICT in teaching and learning in the Indian classroom. This data was collected from the 150 teachers selected from 15 government and private schools of Punjab state of India. In India, basically there are two types of schools, the government school, which are funded by the government, and the other category of the school is the private schools, which are totally self-financed, they are not funded by the government. But on the basis of use of ICT, I divided the school into four levels. The level one school, which have very, very limited use of ICT in the educational task, even the connectivity is limited to only one or two computer in the classroom, in the school only, and they are without having an internet connection and without having a network. And there is also a lack of motivation on the part of teacher because there is not availability of the ICT resources in the school. Then the level two schools, they have well equipped computer classroom, but there is only one computer classroom in the whole school, and the use is also not very intensive and depends on the interest of some teacher. If the teacher want to use the ICT, They took their students on that classroom and they are using the ICT for their teaching purpose. Level 3 school, these are having one or more very well equipped computer classroom. The computers are connected and teachers are generally using the ICT while they are teaching, but the use of ICT is not, it is partially included in the academic plan. Then we have level 4 school, and mostly these are the private schools. They are not funded by the government. These schools have decided that ICT is a distinct element of their educational activities, and there is always someone solving the maintenance problem also, and they have academic plan that includes use of ICT in their instructions. So in India, most of the government schools, they fall under level 1 and 2, but most good private schools come under the level 3 and 4. And I use this research, I use the schools which comes under the level 2, 3 and 4 for this research. The average age of teacher is 35 years old, ranging between the 25 and 60 years for this research work. Both quantitative and qualitative methods were used to collect the data. Questionnaire was developed and implemented to the teacher, and then after that, the qualitative data was collected from the 15 teachers who are randomly selected from the 150 teachers. These are the results of the quantitative data. I can summarize them here. Among the total 150 teachers, 16 teachers, that is 10.6%, they have highly unfavorable attitude towards the use of ICT. 26 have unfavorable, 38 have neutral attitude. 52 teachers out of 150, they have favorable attitude, and 18 teachers have highly favorable attitude towards the use of ICT in the Indian classroom. So it is concluded that most of the teachers have favorable attitude towards using ICT. And I also use the T-test to find out is there any gender differences in the use of ICT in the Indian classroom. And the value of the T-test is 0.29, which is not significant. It means there is no impact of gender in the use of ICT in the Indian classroom. Male and female teacher, the both have same attitude and same beliefs. The qualitative data, 15 interviews complemented the quantitative information, and the all interview transcriptions were categorized into two dimensions. First, to know what is the attitude and belief towards the use of ICT. This study suggests the participant had positive attitude and beliefs towards the use of ICT as teaching tool. Teachers believe that people like to learn with computers. One teacher said, the use of ICT in education adds value to teaching and learning by enhancing the effectiveness of learning. Some other teachers said, ICT motivates us towards learning also. It means ICT motivates the teacher also to give the instruction. It is reliable and provides the interactive learning experiences. It facilitates the communication and promotes the creativity. One teacher said that ICT-based teaching is more used between the class 1st to 10th because we have lot of learning material which is present for the ICT instruction, but from class plus 1, in our school system we have from class 1 to the 12th. From 11 to 12, these two classes, these higher classes, mostly the content is designed by the respective subject instructor. It is not available by the, it is not designed by the experts. Most of the private schools in this study seems to be well furnished and make more use of ICT in teaching in comparison to Government School of India. Government school technology is implemented, but not at classroom level. They are using ICT for the communication with the authorities at administrative level, filing of e-portals and students, but not in classroom. So they use the ICT for the student enrollment to make the record, to attendance, their academic progress, for the payment of fee, for the salary transfer. They are using computers, they are using ICT, but they are not using ICT for the classroom teaching. So the challenges, the use of ICT faced by the teachers, there is lack of access or the resources, including home access, because they find it is very expensive to purchase a computer and to having an internet connection for the use of ICT. And most teachers felt the practical implementation was also difficult due to the lack of ICT resources. There is also inadequate institutional support and the absence of maintenance staff in the schools. And the basic barrier in using ICT in teaching is a poor infrastructure, hardware hazards, and lack of content-related software also. And the technical problems, the teacher also faced these type of technical problems, sometimes failing to connect to the internet when they are going to give the lesson with the help of ICT. There is no internet connection, printers sometimes not working, buffering of the websites, and the teachers have to work on old and outdated computers. And there were not enough training opportunities for teachers for using ICT in the classroom environment also. And there is inadequate pre-service as well as in-service training in ICT. So the present study clearly indicates that the higher secondary teachers of India have favorable attitude and beliefs towards the use of ICT, and there are no gender differences. And this study also revealed that ICT, the use of ICT in teaching in Indian school is insufficient and inadequate. Number of early study also support my study that teachers are not using computers. The small sample size make it difficult to offer any generalization concerning the robustness of the observed result. But this study highlights the two things. The firstly, we have to increase the teacher's confidence in the use of technology. And secondly, we have to allow the teachers to develop lessons that utilize ICT resources to be pedagogically meaningful for their learners. So this study, outcome of the study, that most of the teachers felt confident and happy with the ICT when they were using ICT in the classrooms. So this study also highlighted the need for the further research to be conducted, assessing how best to assist the Indian teachers to develop their ICT skills so that they can use the great use of ICT in the Indian classrooms. Now in India, Prime Ministers have started this mission, that is the Digital India Mission. So we are doing this everything digitally. So we are hoping that in near future, we are using the ICT in all the Indian classrooms. Thank you.